Hello, welcome back to my channel. You're tuned in to Living Modestly Naturally with Rachel Harris. Thank you so much for stopping by. Thank you for all the support, all the likes, all the comments. I greatly appreciate it. In this video that I have for you all, I will be doing I'll be explaining my hair routine, and towards the end of the video I will be doing a short demonstration of how I do a prepoo treatment. My hair is due for a wash, and so I want to bring you all along with me to share what I do on my wash days and also with my hair care regimen. So let's get started. So for my hair care regimen, I mainly I moisturize my hair once every other day. Okay, so for example, if I moisturize my hair on a Sunday, then I'll skip Monday and then moisturize my hair on Tuesday. And then I'll go on in that pattern. I'll skip Wednesday, then moisturize on Thursday. I'll skip Friday, like that. So usually is once every other day. When my hair is in a need of a moisturization pattern, I'll do that. And if it doesn't really need it, like I'll, you know, touch my hair, like I'll test it to see if it feels dry, if it feels, you know, if it doesn't need it, I won't give my hair, I won't moisturize it or seal it. I'll just leave it alone. Or, you know, or if it needs it, then I'll do that. So that's also good. See what your hair likes. See how often you have to moisturize your hair and go with that. So that's how I moisturize my hair. What I use is water. My spray bottle, water is how we moisturize. Or sometimes I put water and aloe vera juice, but I don't have aloe vera juice right now. So I'm using, right now it's just water and my cream. I've been using my cream, my aloe mango butter hair cream. I use that. It has all the oils, it has oils in it. It has what I need in it, so I don't really need to use like a separate oil. So I just use these two to moisturize my hair. My hair was in twists, but now as you can see, I have it in bantu knots to prep it for wash. So that's what I do. For my scalp, I do scalp massages, and I usually do scalp massages. I follow in the same path of once every other day, but it's not as often. I'll do a scalp massage once or twice a week, and I use my Ayurvedic hair oil. And I have a separate video of how I make this, so you can check that out. And also how I moisturize and seal my hair, I also have a separate video showing you how I do that as well. And so I do that. So I do my scalp treatment once or twice a week. I moisturize and seal my hair once every other day. So that's how I do that. Next, moving along to wash day. Okay, so when I wash my hair, I like to do something called a prepoo. And what a prepoo is usually you use oil. An oil or oils, a combination of oils, and you apply it to your hair. Your hair doesn't have to be clean to do a prepoo treatment. I don't do a prepoo treatment with clean hair. I do it on dirty hair. My hair is, because it needs to be shampooed, so I do this treatment prior to doing my shampoo process. And what I usually use is coconut oil, and I'll use Ayurvedic powder like amla, and make like kind of like an Ayurvedic pre-poo type of treatment. But I'm not using my Ayurvedic powders for my pre-poos anymore. I'm taking a break from that, and what I'm using is coconut oil and olive oil. Olive oil has been an oil that's been in my hair care journey for years, but it's just I've been kind of like back and forth with it. You know, I use it sometimes and then I just kind of just left it alone, but now I'm getting back to it because it does do wonders for my hair, like in terms of like keeping my my curls like detangled, and it makes it so much easier when it comes to detangling my hair. And speaking of which, when I detangle my hair, I use mainly my fingers to get rid of all the knots and the tangles. I usually use my fingers. It's been working for me over the years, and what I do is I just take my time, go through each section, and gently just separate the tangles, being very gentle. And so, back to the prepoo. So the prepoo is coconut oil and olive oil I'll be using now, and I already made my mixture, which I will show you before this video is over how I apply it to my hair. So I do prepoo, okay? And after I do my prepoo, I put a bag, a plastic bag. I use a plastic bag, put it over my head, okay? And I usually let my prepoo sit for hours, like 3-4 hours if I'm home during the day, or if not, like tonight, I'm gonna sleep with the prepoo treatment in my hair. So I'm gonna let it rest overnight in my hair, and then tomorrow morning I'll be continuing my wash day process by shampooing and all of that. So I'm gonna be doing that tonight. I'll just leave it in my hair overnight, and then in the morning, all right, it's time for wash. So what I'm gonna use for wash is this. This is what I use. I use castile soap. I've been using castile soap again for a number of years. Been using castile soap. And again, it's like off and on, but I've been consistent even last year. Last year I've been using castile soap like it was like clockwork. Anytime I needed it to wash my hair, that's what I'm using. So this time around, I'm going to be using Dr. Jacobs Naturals. And it's the pure castile, 2x thicker, viscosity, almond honey, castile liquid soap. So this is what it is. Can't wait to use this brand. I've been using Dr. Bronner's, the lavender scent. The lavender, but I stopped using it. So I'm gonna try this one and see how it goes. But castile soap is something I really love to use for my hair. And I'm gonna show you some of the ingredients it has. It has purified water, it has spunified coconut oil, it has spunified olive oil, it has potassium oleate, it has vegetable glycerin, cocoa glucoside, it has natural almond honey fragrance, sea salt, the aloe vera, vitamin E. These have things that I know for a fact is gonna work for my hair. Like, I know the coconut oil, it has the olive oil, vegetable glycerin, all these things. I'm so excited to try this. But castile soap mainly has been the soap of choice that I use to clean my hair, because my hair tends to, my scalp tends to get dirty easily, because I get dandruff. I struggle with dandruff. I've been struggling with dandruff for years, ever since I was young. Struggle with dandruff, and whenever I'm shampooing my hair or cleansing, I need something that is gonna lift that dirt off. It's gonna lift that the flakes off my scalp. I need something that's gonna lift them flakes off my scalp so that I can be able to get a clean scalp. Although I don't use sulfate shampoos, you might say, you know, why don't you just use a shampoo with like a detergent in it or like a sulfate? That's a little bit harsh. But once I started using castile soap, I noticed that it gets the job done. Just like as if I were to use a sulfate shampoo, it gets the job done. I'm able to lift the dirt off of my scalp and my hair as well with ease and no problems. So definitely that's what I use. But you could use whatever shampoo is good for you, whatever you find. If you want a more gentle cleansing shampoo, you could use something that's more moisturizing. A moisturizing shampoo. Those shampoos usually just give you a gentle clean. It, you know, doesn't really strip your hair of the oils and stuff like that. But as far as my scalp goes, I need something to really get that dirt off. And Castile has been tried and true in my regimen, and I stick to it. And I also have another brand, the Equate Pure Beauty Castile Soap Lavender. And it's a multi-purpose soap. And that's another thing about Castile, is that you could use it as a, you could use it for your hair, you could use it for your body, you could use it for your face. Like, it's different types of things you can use it for. And that's what I love about it. You could use it for different things. I can wash my body, I can wash my face, I can wash my hair. So it's just a multi-purpose type of product, and I love that about it. So wash my hair. After I wash my hair, then I move on to a deep treatment mask. I know the norm is to wash your hair with the shampoo and then proceed to a rinse out conditioner. But me, what has been working for me over the years is going straight into a deep treatment mask. I don't do a rinse out conditioner. And if I do rinse out conditioner, that's like if I'm doing like a co-wash, a conditioning wash type of thing. And that's a rare, I do that on a rare occasion. I'll do a conditioning like rinse or whatever. But that's on a rare occasion. I normally just shampoo and go straight into a deep treatment. That's how it's been. And what I tend to do is when I put my deep treatment in, I just leave it for hours until I'm ready to rinse it out. I, you know, do whatever I need to do, run errands. If I need to go out, I'm going out. That conditioner is going to be in my hair. I just wrap it up and keep it moving. So what I'm going to be doing for my deep treatment mask is I'm doing a do-it-yourself, a DIY treatment mask. And what I'm going to be using is 100% organic banana powder. So it's a banana and honey. I'm going to do a banana and honey treatment. So I'll make that mixture tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll be doing my shampoo routine. And so I'll be mixing all of my ingredients to make my deep treatment mask. And banana have been something that I've used throughout the years. I started off with using like baby food. Yes, I use baby food in my hair. Yes, I do. I'll take the baby food, like the little Gerber jar foods. The banana flavor, the banana kind, I'll put that in, take a few jars, put it in a bowl, then add some oils to it and stuff like that. Put it in my hair. And then I'll let it sit. And let me tell you that my hair was coming out soft. It was coming out. My curls were defined. So don't knock it till you try it. I'm telling you, you know, but now I'm like, let me try the banana powder. Bananas have a lot of good nutrients and benefits to it. So I'm continuing to use it. But instead of the baby food, I'm going to do the banana powder. I could keep it in. I could have the product longer. I could keep it longer. And plus, you know, I'll just try it that way. And plus, it's a powder. I can control how much or how little that I use. And I just really, I'm looking forward to using it in powder form. And so, yes. So I'm going to be doing that as my treatment. After I do my treatment, I leave it in. Again, put a shower cap or a plastic bag. I use plastic bags to, you know, when I'm doing my treatments, I put a plastic bag over my head. And I let it sit for a number of hours, as long as I want it to sit in there. And then I rinse it out. And then I proceed to style. And what I like to do is I like to keep my hair stretched. And so ways that I tend to keep my hair stretched is by doing a roller set. So I tend to do a roller set in my hair. That's been my staple method of stretching my hair. I do a roller set. So that's something that I hope to show you guys in future videos. So that's all for my explanation of how I do my hair care routine. I hope that helps you and gives you some information that maybe you can incorporate. Again, this is not end all be all. This is not, you know, you must do this and this is how, this is what I do. Please experiment with your hair. Please find out what works for you, because what works for me may not work for you, but I want to share. I want to share what I know, because maybe something within the my regimen, if you incorporate it, maybe it might work. You could try it. Just to try, I'm here to share. This is what it's about. And last but not least, if you are, when it comes to deep treatment mask, if you're not into making stuff, putting stuff together, a product I would like to recommend to you that I've used throughout the entire 2018, I've been using this thing, you know, when I bought it, you know, I was looking for something that I could just use without having to make anything. I was kind of like in that mood of, you know, let me just buy something and just stick with it and see how it works. And so I got my hands on this brand here. It's TGIN. Thank God it's natural. And it's a honey miracle hair mask. It's made with raw honey, olive oil, and it's an intense deep treating conditioner for dry, damaged, and color treated hair. It has no parabens, sulfates, petrolatum, lanolin, artificial colors, or animal testing. So it has all that stuff. And I noticed that, again, it has ingredients in it that work for my hair. That honey, that olive oil, like I went back to show you, these are things that I know works for my hair. And as you can see, like the ingredients, the first ingredient is water, then it has raw honey, then it has olive oil, it has those top three, then it has jojoba seed oil, that's a good oil too, aloe vera, my hair loves aloe vera juice, it loves that, and then it has all these other alcohols and stuff like that in it. It has cones and stuff like that in it. And so, yeah, so this is a good product if you wanted to get a good treatment mask. It works for my hair. My hair is like very coily and very tight, like little ringlets, like very tight. In certain areas, it's like my shrinkage. I'm telling you, my shrinkage is to another level. It's amazing. Like my hair comes down to here, like, but it goes all, when it's ready to shrink, it can't stretch all the way down to here, but when it shrink, it go vroom, like it's just like, oh my gosh, like where did my hair go? It's there, but it's like, I gotta be like, where is it? I gotta be making sure like I pull down just to make sure it's still there. Cause when I tell you it shrink like it could get me right. I could walk out of here. I could be Rapunzel 1 minute, the next minute it's going up like, is like to my shoulders. It's like, where did your hair go? But that's the thing, that's the amazing thing about natural hair and how, you know, God created our hair and the way that and what it does is so beautiful, so remarkable. We're definitely fearfully and wonderfully made, you know, remember that, ladies. You know, like, you're fearfully and wonderfully made, and God didn't make any mistakes. It's just amazing. But yeah, so that's that. Thank you so much for tuning into this segment. Now, quickly, oh my gosh, I'm 19 minutes, oh gosh, into this video. Hopefully, you're still watching. I'm going to show you what I do, last but not least, with my Prepoo. Let me show you what I do. So as you can see, my hair is in several different sections here. Okay, bantu knots. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take down this first section. Okay. This is what it looks like. And quickly. Hopefully I don't make a mess. Take some of that. I just dropped some. I'm just gonna just apply it to my hair, just like that. I'm not spraying my hair with any water, I'm just applying it. Because the Prepoo is something that helps to create a barrier. So as the shampoo is cleansing your scalp, shampoo is mainly for the scalp, it's cleansing your scalp, it doesn't remove all the oils in your hair. Your hair can still end up being nice and soft. So that's what the Prepoo does. It helps the hair maintain its softness while getting your scalp clean and your hair clean as well. But it just creates a barrier. So I'm just applying it here, making sure I get the edges and everything. I'm rolling it back up. So there you go. Get these sections on the side. Again, start here. So this is what it's looking like. Just put the treatment there. Okay, I'm going to do one more section on camera and then I'm gonna finish the rest of this off camera and then that. I'll do one more on this side. So far I did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm gonna finish the rest of my hair off camera. Be back soon. Alrighty, so as you can see, I am done. I put the oil, the coconut oil. This is what I have left, the coconut oil and the olive oil mixture for my Prepoo. I'm gonna save the rest of this for another wash day session, but I put in all the sections here. I don't know if the camera is really showing that it's, you know, the shininess. Oh my gosh, this is bullshit hair. Oh gosh. Yeah, so that's what it looks like. So very quickly, this is what I like to do. I like to use two bags, okay? I use two shopping bags to get you any kind of shopping bag or a plastic bag. Whatever you can recycle and reuse, you could use that in your hair. Or if you don't like that, you could just go to the beauty supply store and get you a pack of the conditioning caps and stuff like that they sell. But I like to use my shopping bags. It's a way to use them, but sometimes when you buy groceries and stuff like that, sometimes the stores tend to give you a whole lot of shopping bags, and so I make good use of it by using them for my hair care treatment. So take two, put it over my hair like this, then bring it forward. Bring it forward. And then twist on the side. Twist the other side. Okay. You have two sections like this. And then now, tie it. Not double knot it. Okay, voila. So now I'm gonna leave this, let it set overnight. As you can see, my shirt got dirty with the oil. So again, another thing when you're doing these type of treatments. Make sure you wear clothes that you don't mind getting dirty or getting oil or stains on. You know, don't wear your best clothes when you're doing these type of things, because some treatments can get a little messier than others. So yeah, but that's all for now. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for the likes. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for the interaction that I received from some of you in my last video. I really appreciated that, you know, the comments and just the questions that you have. Just thank you so much for that. I appreciate it. Lets me know that, you know, you care about my content and that, you know, you care about what I'm doing. And it's for you all, you know, it's to share what I know. And again, this channel is, I want it to be different types of things. So sometimes you're gonna see hair stuff, sometimes you're gonna see cooking stuff, sometimes you might see, you know, just me putting out a video of a word of encouragement for you all. So it's different types of things. So hopefully you can stick around for it all. So thank you so much for watching. This is part one of my video. This is Prepoo. Next video, I will be doing my shampoo and conditioning for part two. So stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. See you all next time. Bye.